Hi, this is our second tutorial about how to get started with TRAE IDE. So previously when I was a developer without AI, I always forgot about the git command and sometimes have to search through Stack Overflow or Google search to be able to find the right git command that I want to run. But right now you can do it much smarter with TRAE. So in this video, I'll show you some tips and tricks on how to use Git smarter and faster with TRAE IDE. Let's get started. So the first thing that I want to do is to clone GitHub repository. So right now, let's just use the TRAE agent open source project. So if we click on the source control, right now you'll see all the current merge requests under our main branch. And we are currently under our main branch. So one of the best practices of using Git is that when you're developing on your local, especially working on a shared project like TRAE Agent, you want to create your own local branch first before committing to your main branch. Instead of doing it with our terminal, I'll do it with Builder. So let's ask Builder to check out a new branch called, give it a name, local testing. Okay, so it actually just run the terminal command for us, but I'm just too lazy to type it myself. All right, so right now, I'll go back to actually editing some code. So now we've added a grok client to our TRAE agent project, and now I want to commit this change. Here you can visually see what file has changed. And here's the sweet part. So if we click on this button or just click using command G, we can actually let AI generating a commit message for us. So this is really helpful when you are making a lot of changes or having a very complex big PR coming up. So here it writes in a very developer style, no caps, and also captures what we've done in this change. Okay, looks good, and we can click commit. So right now you can here you can visually see that this commit has been pushed to our local testing branch. So but right now the change is in my local, and what if I want to publish this branch? Let's just click on this. So it actually detects that we don't have the permission to publish this branch directly to GitHub. And we have to create a fork and make a PR first. So let's do it. So now if we go to the GitHub repo, it just asks us to create a PR. And besides checking out new branches, you can always communicate with Builder to make terminal commands. And plus another trick before we end this video. Here you can actually see that all my terminal commands are auto-run by our builder. So how did I do that? So if you go to the agents tab, and here you can actually select if you want to automatically run commands and MCP tools for your agent. And here I turn it on for IDEs. And for solo mode, it's default on for auto-run. Okay, that's all for today. Hope you like it.